Kashmiris across the world observed the Black Day on 22nd October. They shouted anti-Pakistan slogans while demanding freedom from its clutches. Pakistan has misruled the region for more than 73 years and has now ramped up its exploitative designs in collusion with China to further plunder it. It has used brute force to muzzle the voice of demand and dissent and is now working overtime to change the demography of the region so that it has free run with the projects it wants to install in the region.
Observing 22nd October as Black Day, people in Pakistan-occupied Kashmir took to streets and carried out a march against the occupier Pakistan. Carrying floats demanding freedom from the clutches of Islamabad, they sloganeered against the political masters of the country, who they accused of plunder and exploitation. Kashmiris observed the day as Black Day because it was on this day in 1947 when Pakistan's tribal militias attacked the region and gained control over its resources and affairs. Fearing his and his people's lives, the ruler of the then princely state of Jammu and Kashmir, Hari Singh, signed the instrument of accession with New Delhi on 26 October 1947, subsuming his entire territory into the sovereign nation of India. But Pakistan never vacated the place and has been illegally occupying thousands of kilometers of territory even today. It has even disregarded the United Nations in doing so. Kashmiris in POK, however, say that they will never accept Pakistan as their parent or home state and will continue their struggle until they ensure freedom. The anti-Pakistan anger is not just limited to the confines of Pakistan-controlled territories, but it has been simmering amongst Kashmiris living around the globe. From Washington to Tokyo, to Malaysia to Nepal, a number of Kashmiri activists and their supporters observed the Black Day. They also highlighted the state-sponsored atrocities being committed by Pakistan in the region. Pakistan, they said, has been employing excessive force to muzzle the voice of demand and dissent. The press is censored so that the world doesn't get to know the reality. They also said that Islamabad has been working overtime to peddle lies on Kashmiri history, to change present narrative and to bring a favorable change in future through demographic alteration. However, Kashmiris are not buying any of its tricks and have called out its dubious designs both at home and at international platforms. Meanwhile, Kashmiris in India, who unlike Pakistani state, are equal and empowered citizens of the country, asked Pakistani PM and army generals to stay away from Kashmiri affairs.
मैं गुजारिश करूंगा इमरान खान साहब को और जनरल को कि प्लीज आप अपना ध्यान रखें, जहां पे आपकी गवर्नमेंट चलाती है आर्मी और हमें आप तकलीफ दे रहे हैं, आपको उससे क्या मिलेगा? आप अपना ध्यान रखें, हमें अपना काम करने दें, हम अपने कार्य में हैं, वी आर अ प्रोग्रेसिंग कंट्री। सो वी रिक्वेस्ट यू इमरान खान साहब, आप अपना अपने काम से मतलब रखें।
पाकिस्तानी प्राइम मिनिस्टर मेक्स टॉल क्लेम्स ऑफ वर्किंग टायरलेसली फॉर द वेलफेयर ऑफ कश्मीरीज। यूनाइटेड नेशंस एंड अदर राइट ग्रुप्स हाउएवर हैव टर्म्ड इट्स एक्शंस एज ह्यूमन राइट्स वायलेशंस। Army generals who hold greater sway in the country's politics are the de facto administrators of the region. They have had no regards for the democratic functioning and have accorded a second-class citizen treatment to the people.